This is a response to the video by Will Smith, the very, very super famous, wonderful, loved movie star, about his movie. I don't even know what the movie was, but it has to do with, you know, that happy thing which he did with his son. If you want something, get it, period. If you want something, get it, period. Ladies and gentlemen, it's actually a lot easier than said. Yeah, it's done easier than it said. It really is. You got to have a goal. I mean, if you wouldn't go shooting whatever, you gotta go shooting without a target. You got to have a target. You gotta first have a target, and then you gotta go and get it. Has to do with gotta imagine what you want. You gotta imagine what you wanna give to other people in order to be able to get you what you want. Because you won't get what you want if you don't give something to other people. You got to imagine how you go about getting this to other people. How you got to imagine all those steps. You got to feel it, smell it, of how you go through it. You know, if you would go into the jungle, you would smell and feel and smell the jungle before you go there. So when you arrive, actually, you're not surprised how it feels and smells, and that's how you actually will survive. There's a gentleman out there who has a book called Flawless Execution. I think it's Flawless Execution, and I think the gentleman's name is Murphy something. Anyway, he was a fighter pilot, one of those F-16s. Boom, 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 boom. He turned marketing or business consultant, like me. Well, probably not like me, probably an awful lot more successful. But the point is that he says that when they were fighting, going up on a mission, that it's a great book, by the way. You should just simply read the book. It is so phenomenal. If you want to succeed in business, that is. Or if you want to succeed in marriage, that is. Even though it is all about business. He says, before they flew the mission, they imagined everything which could go wrong, right, and everything. Just the whole mission. You know, maybe you go up there, maybe you think you have two enemies, two other airplanes, and maybe there are four. Maybe you have not enough gasoline, maybe whatever. Okay? So they imagined everything possibly, because when you fly up there 1,000 miles an hour or whatever they fly, you have no time to think, he says. You need to have it all worked out. And they did tests where they hooked up the pilots on some electronic measurement things. I'm sure there's a name for it, which I don't know. And I found out that when they did this imagination about the whole thing, it reacted the same way than when they were hooked up on those things and really flying. Which means you're creating the same emotion, and that's what's important. And this is not putting the devil on the wall, you know, like, oh, why would you imagine all the bad things? No, that's like, oh, if that happens, that's what you do. Lawyers do that. Did you see the movie? By Tom Cruise? A Few Good Men, many eons ago. He did role-playing. There's three lawyers who were fighting against, well, whatever, you know, role-playing. And Tom Cruise would stand there and would make a question to the accused or to the whatever, and he would say something, and then that lawyer, in fact, the question was, so, did the person get hurt in any other way? And the other person says, you mean rather than that he died? Oh, shit, Tom Cruise said. Damn it, I always do this. See, you got to mull it over. It's called coaching. It's called role-playing. It's called going through it. Test runs. It's called test runs with your mind. The best test runs there are. The best test runs there are. The test runs with your mind. Not saying they eliminated real test runs, but boy, are they good. So, you got to go and get things. And here's one thing, and actually I haven't gone through the part of getting things yet. Somehow got sidetracked here, which is okay though, for me at least. I hope for you too. Here's what I find out why people don't go for what they want. What they want doesn't excite them. How can that be? How can you want something that doesn't excite you? Well, it's not big enough in many cases. It's not the real thing in many cases. For instance, a doctor, a small doctor in his business might want a good, beautiful, effective staff. No, that's not what he really wants. What he really wants is help a lots of people, make a lots of money, have a lots of free time, have a bunch of good reputation, retire a little early, have some vacations. That's what he wants. Not this other in between insignificant things, which are not necessarily always insignificant. They may be tools to help you to get there, but if you put most attention on those little tools, they don't excite you, they become a hustle, because you're having your attention on the wrong target. And also, I see it very often in business, people don't want, they want to improve too little. Let's just say you, whatever money you make, and you say, oh, 15% would be great. Well, it sounds good, because that 15% you think will make your car payment, your house payment. You will like, wow, you know what? Usually, most of the time, the hustle it takes to get it isn't worth to get the 15%. You got to get more. You got to, when it comes to business and to most other things, you got to double and triple your expectation. Those are the things which usually will excite you. Yeah. You gotta, as they said, reach for the star to maybe get the moon, something like that, okay? You got to do that. Otherwise, you're not getting excited. Not going high enough doesn't excite people. That's why usually I don't take on clients who don't want to double, triple, and quadruple. Because if they don't want that, if they don't have a burning desire to want double and triple and quadruple their business, you know what? I'm coming at them with a cannon to expand their business. They will not want that. They'll go, oh, we'll do a little here, a little there, and a little here and a little there doesn't work. Let me give you an example in airplanes. You know, an airplane on the ground, safe, good, it rolls, you know, and then it takes off. It starts rattling. It's dangerous. You could fly into little birds. You could fly into small airplanes. You could fly into buildings in the mountains. All kinds of things. And that climbing up, apparently, it's dangerous. You use a lots of gasoline to climb up there. People in the airplane, if you look around, there's always a few scared ones around. And if it rattles a lot, even you might get a little burble. Oh, Jesus, this is enough today. Okay? So, what... When you get there, this is kind of a little bit taking off. This is like the 10-15% taking off. You got to go through that and then go higher up. Oh my God, is there beautiful sailing. So business people always do that. This is why the effort to go to a little bit is not enough. All right? Another one of those examples, I think it was Rose Kennedy who's told her son JF Kennedy, who wanted apparently, just a rumor I heard, I'm not even sure it's true, but so what, that he wanted to run for vice president. And she said, it's as easy to lose for vice president as it is to lose for president. Personally, I think she's totally wrong. It's easier to lose for vice president than for president. Absolutely. You're automatically going for more control if you want to be the, I mean, you know, Joe Biden, he was picked. He was total effect. And he is. It's easy. I mean, you know, you have a little puppet there, you know. He's not in control. He had no choice over this. He had to wait for luck. Literally. Doesn't mean he didn't do certain things to get in that level to be able to be picked. But he, ladies and gentlemen, shoot for the big thing. For instance, another thing. You want to lose 5, 10, 15 pounds. So, okay. I should lose 10 to 15 pounds. My wife keeps telling me for 20-some years now. 20-some years I haven't lost a pound or seldom have, thanks God, also not gained too many. Either way, you see, it's not... I'm not going to go through the hustle I'm supposed to go through. Maybe change my breakfast a little bit. Maybe change my dinner. Whatever it is to lose... Because it doesn't bother me enough. That doesn't mean it shouldn't come off. My ladies and gentlemen, you know, there got to be something which excites you. Losing weight in itself doesn't excite me. So maybe one day I wake up and go, wow, I'm getting really tired on skiing. I can only make it one run. That would probably motivate me to go, ooh, it's time to lose some weight. So find that thing which burns your butt. Find that thing which gets you. Maybe that's 4 times as much business. Maybe that's more vacation. Maybe that's a greater reputation. Maybe that's like, I did it. For what? Who cares? I just did it. It wouldn't matter what it is, but find something which excites you, and then, only then, and only then will you be willing to go through whatever hassle it takes to get there. Because no matter what it is, there will be some hassle. Okay? There will be hassle. There will be hassle, even if you kind of like try to crawl into a hole and live out your life there because you don't want to be out there competing. Even that will be a hassle. So you may as well go for a little more hassle, all right? And no matter how many things are against you, as Mr. Henry Ford said, yes, everything is against you, but keep in mind, airplanes take off against the air, against the wind. Boy, do they have lots of airplane stories. I hope this helped you. I hope you're going for the guts. I hope you're going to go for what it takes to go where you want. Find that thing which, you know, it's not necessarily the thing you think it is. This is maybe one of the problems why you're not, so to say, go there. And if you think you, that's what it is, more money, whatever, please consider my statement about you're probably not making it big enough. The hassle to get 5, 10, 15% improvement usually isn't worth for most of us to act. So let's make it 100%, 200%. And that may have to change your whole operation. That's another thing. When you make your goal very big, you know, you very often your whole way of doing things might have to change. And that's the good thing. Because as long as you want to do things the way you do, just work harder, do more, more often, more, you know, like a telemarketer. Oh, let's make more calls. Maybe I'll sell more. You know what? You'll never go anywhere. A different way of doing things needs to be developed. That's how we advance. It's not about doing more better. That has its point. It has its value. But it is only a small part of it. You got to like, what else can be done? How else can I go about it? Keep in mind, do not forget that it's not necessarily the way and how you get there. It's the going there. It's the arriving there, you know, and what that is. It's not necessarily having a large practice or a large business which you want. It may be something ideally different because what you want. For instance, when I was 20 years old and 21 and I finished engineering school, I wanted to see the world. And I didn't want to see it on a vacation, and I couldn't possibly imagine how I could do that on my engineering thing. So I didn't try to save money. I didn't try to rack up vacation days and whatever it may be. And I didn't want to wait till I'm 57 and finally can travel. I changed my complete profession. I became a waiter. I went into the hotel business. I worked in 12 countries, in 4 continents. I speak languages. I saw the world. When I was young, I worked there. I lived there. I made and spent from French francs to German marks to English pounds to Indian rubies to name it, Italian liras, African. I don't even know what the money was down there where I lived there for a couple of years. That was my goal. That excited me. All the hassles. All of a sudden, machine or engineer meant nothing to me anymore as such because it was unimportant from what I now wanted. Dumped it just like that. And of course, today I'm still very happy that I did it because, well, I don't know, I can fix my plumbing at home sometimes. Ladies and gentlemen, take it to your heart. Big goals. Go for it. Don't give up. Run for it. And realize there will be some hassle getting there. But isn't that part of the fun? No world championship is ever achieved without some hassle. So just don't mind the hassle. That's nothing. That's the fun of it. You can't have big wins. You can't win world championship it not being hard. It's not possible. So don't try to be this super successful business person and whatever it is your goal might be and not have any hassles. That's not going to happen. So just embrace the hassle. Goodbye.